In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you.
This morning, we are praying for all parishioners. Let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters,
all praise
in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fall, through my most gracious fall. Therefore ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints,
and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A reading from the letter of St. James. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can that faith save him? If a brother or sister has nothing to wear and has no food for the day, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat well, but you do not give them the necessities of the body, what good is it? So also, faith of itself, if it does not have works, is dead. Indeed, someone might say, you have faith and I have works. Demonstrate your faith to me without works, and I will demonstrate my faith to you from my works. You believe that God is one, you do well. Even the demons believe that and tremble. Do you want proof, you ignoramus, that faith without works is useless? Was not Abraham, our father, justified by works when he offered his son Isaac upon the altar? You see that faith was active along with his works, and faith was completed by the works. Thus the scripture was fulfilled that says, Abraham believed God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, and he was called the friend of God. See how a person is justified by works and not by faith alone. For just as a body without a spirit is dead, so also faith without works is dead. The word of the Lord. Blessed the man who greatly delights in the Lord's commands. Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house. His generosity shall endure forever. Light shines through the darkness for the upright. He is gracious and merciful and just. Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just man shall be in everlasting remembrance.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus summoned the crowd with his disciples and said to them, whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake and that of the gospel will save it. What profit is there for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? What could one give in exchange for his life? Whoever is ashamed of me and of my words in this faithless and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of when he comes in his Father's glory with the holy angels. He also said to them, Amen, I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death until they see that the kingdom of God has come in power. Sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Yesterday, Jesus was asking us, who is he in our life? Then we ask Jesus who we are for him. And today we can see that he is inviting us to follow him. Why following Jesus is so difficult? You know why? Because following doesn't mean to go side by side. Following Jesus means never sees his face. We see his back. We are behind him. So we don't have even imagine what he thinks about us, what is his emotion about us, what is his expression about us. We see his back. Following means go behind, not side by side. This is why following Jesus is very difficult in our lives, because we want to see and we want to know what he thinks about us. But maybe at some point on this journey, Jesus will turn back to see our face. So, my friends, we are invited to follow him. But we are invited to see the world as his back. He is the one who sees what is in front of us. His eyes can see what's there. Our eyes can just trustly follow his back, like in the darkness. This is why following Jesus is so difficult. But this is why he's telling us, trust me. I can see better than you. You can even see my back. We will be safe. Trust me. As Jesus invites us to follow him, we turn our hearts and minds to the Father and place our petitions before him.
For the church, that Christ may continue to bless her with grace and wisdom and bring his love to the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For political leaders, may the spirit of wisdom help them govern with truth and integrity. And we especially pray for world peace in the Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are persecuted for their faith, may Christ strengthen them in the face of suffering or hardship. We pray to the Lord. For this family of believers, may the Lord continue to bless us and help us grow in faith, hope, and charity. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, may they be welcomed into the eternal joy of God's presence. We pray to the Lord. And for the special intentions of this Mass for parishioners, we pray to the Lord.
Loving God, hear this and all the prayers we hold within our hearts. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are God, God of our creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of man's hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are Lord God of our creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of man's hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink. Pray, brethren, my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim: Holy,
holy, holy, holy,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. May holy, therefore, these gifts be prayed by sending down your Spirit upon the like that you fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
Lord,
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And let us share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called the supper of the Lamb. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that all who believe in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now go in peace to love and serve the Lord by your witness and through your life. Thanks be to God.